Young Thomas Jones came home from school in sad and solemn air. He did not kiss his mother's cheek, nor pull his sister's hair. He hungered not for apples, and spoke in dismal tones. 'Twas very clear misfortune drear had happened Thomas Jones. "My precious child," his mother cried, "what, what is troubling you? You're hurt, you're ill, you've failed in school. Oh, tell us what to do." And Thomas Jones made answer in a dull, despairing way, "I've got to write an essay on the Indian today." His tallest sister ran to him, compassion in her eye. His smallest sister pitied him, nor knew the reason why. And all that happy family forsook their work and play to hunt up information on the Indian today. They read of Hiawatha and sad Ramona's woe. You find encyclopedias where'er they chance to go. They bought a set of Cooper and searched it through and through, while Thomas Jones sat mournfully and told them what to do. For 3 whole days the library was like a moving van. "Is Mr. Jones," each caller asked, "a literary man?" But day by day more pitiful became young Thomas' plight, because, alas, the more he read, the more he could not write. "Write what you know," his mother begged. She stirred not from his side. "I do not know one single thing," that wretched child replied. "Help me, won't you? Don't you care?" And when assistance came, "Don't help me, don't, it isn't fair," he pleaded just the same. The night before the fateful day was quite the worst of all. Black came upon the house of Jones, descended like a pall. All pleasure paled, all comfort failed, and laughter seemed a sin. "For, oh, tomorrow," Thomas wailed, "it must be handed in." When lo, the voice of great Aunt Jones came sternly through the door. "I cannot stand the state of things one single minute more. The training of a fractious child is plainly not my mission. But Thomas Jones goes straight upstairs and write that composition." And Thomas Jones went straight upstairs and sat him down alone. And though I grant a stranger thing was surely never known, in 2 short hours he returned serenely to display 6 neatly written pages on the Indian today. The teacher read them to the class and smiled a well-pleased smile. She praised his simple language and his calmly flowing style. "And though," she said, "he does not rise to any lofty height, 'tis wonderful how easily young Thomas Jones can write."